Well, I knew that Francesco Geminiani had spent periods of his life in Dublin because I grew up in Dublin, and one week in music school for homework we had to write an essay about a composer who had a connection to Ireland. So I chose Francesco Geminiani, and I had no idea at the time that I'd end up specialising in baroque music and playing lots of his music. But I've always felt that I can hear this connection to folk music in his writing. So I decided to research that area. And then when I was looking at the Irish tunes, I was looking at the first collection of Irish music, which was published in 1724. And one of the first tunes was a set of variations on an Irish tune written by the Italian composer Lorenzo Bocchi. So I looked into his life and was delighted to find out he was actually a cellist. And he'd written two cello sonatas which have never been recorded that I can find, so it just seemed like a great connection. I've played a lot of concerts here and I always love coming back. It feels like a home, which is what it is. And it's great to feel really connected to history. I love the fact that the music I play feels like a connection to the past. We're playing music in a way that people would have heard it hundreds of years ago. So to be in a house that Handel and Jimi Hendrix upstairs lived in, and to feel really connected by the geography of the place, is really special.
Thank you. The album explores the interaction between Irish traditional music and Italian Baroque composers who visited Dublin in the 18th century. Today we're playing the Irish half of the programme. So we're playing tunes from the first ever printed collection of Irish music, which was published in 1724. And we're also playing a few O'Carolan tunes. Turlough O'Carolan was an Irish harpist and composer from the 18th century, and I find his music really interesting. He came from a line of Irish harpists, so his writing combines the Irish harping tradition with elements of folk music and also an influence of Italian Baroque compositions. We tried out a lot of tunes, but in the end we just chose the ones that felt the strongest musically and the ones we liked the most, so it wasn't really difficult to process. Then we realised after choosing them that we'd chosen one of O'Carolan's first known compositions, which was She Bheog She Bhor, and also his last composition, his beautiful Farewell to Music. So that was really nice to realise that we'd chosen one of his first and his last compositions. The pieces had all been transcribed for treble clef instruments, so Eimear and I spent a few days working through the tunes and trying them out in different instruments, trying some out in the cello, and then eventually we harmonised them and added Aileen in on the harp. We tried to find a soundboard that would work well with both the historical instruments, so we had Baroque cello and Baroque harp, and also with the Irish flute. And in the end, I think it works really nicely how the melody sort of passes between treble instruments and the bass, with the harp providing the harmony. It's been such a strange and quiet few months for everybody, and personally for me, it made me realise how important sharing music is for my own sense of well-being. So when I get to do days like today, to play music that I really care about with fantastic colleagues, it's just such a treat and it's really therapeutic for me actually. And it's great to see how people are adapting to the challenges that we face this year with live performances, and to see that people are keeping music going.